God will surely accomplish what he said. We must know that God does nothing without reason. God is the one who speaks and fulfills, and that very story of God's zeal is the Bible.
The eternal and unchanging word of God. One story
60. Ezekiel, know that I am God. Ezekiel chapter 1 to chapter 48. The book of Ezekiel is the fourth book of prophets. To understand the book of Ezekiel, it is not easy to interpret that many visions and apocalypse contained in the book of Ezekiel, both literally and in meaning. Also, if the book of Ezekiel is approached historically, it becomes a study of history. Therefore, the book of Ezekiel should be viewed like Isaiah and Jeremiah. The crimes of God's people, the punishment for crimes, the grace of God who does not forget even during punishment, and God who is the subject of salvation. In other words, what God ultimately wants to say through the book of Ezekiel is to find out what the contents of reproof is and how to live through God's salvation. Of course, the core of God's salvation is Jesus Christ. Ezekiel's historical background. The book of Ezekiel reveals that the time when Ezekiel received revelation from God through a vision was on the 5th of the month. It was the 5th year of the exile of King Jehoiakim. After King Josiah died, the people made Jehoahaz, the third of his four sons, also called Shalom, as king. But Jehoahaz did evil in the sight of God and was deposed by the king of Egypt after 3 months. And Jehoiakim, the second son of King Josiah, became king by the king of Egypt. Jehoiakim had the name Eliakim, but the king of Egypt changed his name to Jehoiakim. Jehoiakim ruled southern Judah for 11 years, and he also did evil before God. He killed prophet Uriah and cut the scroll that recorded the word of God with a sword and burned it. Eventually, Jehoiakim was attacked by King Nebuchadnezzar of Babylon and was bound by chains and taken to Babylon. This was the first Babylonian invasion. Next, Jehoiakim, the son of Jehoiakim, also called Jeconiah or Coniah, became king by the king of Babylon. About 3 months after he became king, he was deposed by the king of Babylon and taken captive to Babylon. At this time, the prophet Ezekiel was also taken captive. This was the second Babylonian invasion. The king of Babylon took Jehoiakim captive and made Zedekiah, the fourth son of Josiah, as king. So, when Ezekiel saw his first vision, it was the 5th year since Zedekiah became king. This was the time when the work of the prophet Jeremiah was coming to an end and Judah's spiritual condition was at its worst. What is God's people's sins? Through Ezekiel, God starts with the words, "The Israelites are a tribe that revolted, a rebellion tribe. The tribe of Israel had hardened and obstinate not to listen to God's words. They abandoned God's laws and did not follow God's decrees, defiled the holy sanctuary with all vile images and all detestable practices, worshipped idols, rejected God's laws and did not follow his decrees, and desecrated his Sabbaths, said to God, 'The Lord does not see us. The Lord has forsaken the land,' relied on nations, did not act just in God's ways and did not act right in God's ways. They forgot God. One of their biggest problems was that the shepherds did not care for the Israelites. That is why a true shepherd must come." God's punishment for the sins of God's people. God punished and will punish God's people for their sins. Their destruction through God's punishment is the way they can survive. God said to his people, "I will cut off the supply of food in Jerusalem. The people will eat rationed food in anxiety and drink rationed water in despair. For food and water will be scarce. They will be appalled at the sight of each other and will waste away because of their sin. When I shoot at you with my deadly destruction of arrows of famine, I will shoot to destroy you. I will bring more and more famine upon you and cut off your supply of food. I will send famine and wild beasts against you, and they will leave you childless. Plague and bloodshed will sweep through you, and I will bring the sword against you. I will inflict punishment on you in the sight of the nations, because all of your detestable idols. I will do to you what I have never done before and will never do again. Therefore, in your midst, fathers will eat their children, and children will eat their fathers. I will inflict punishment on you and will scatter all your survivors to the winds. I myself will withdraw my favor. I will not look on you with pity or spare you. A third of your people will die of the plague or perish by famine inside you. A third will fall by the sword outside your walls, and a third I will scatter to the winds and pursue with drawn swords. I will not look on you with pity or spare you. I will repay you in accordance with your conduct and the detestable practices among you. Then you will know that it is I, the Lord, who strikes the blow. Therefore, I will deal with them in anger. I will not look on them with pity or spare them. Although they shout in my my ears, I will not listen to them. When terror comes, they will seek peace, but there will be none. Calamity upon calamity will come, and rumor upon rumor. I will deal with them according to their conduct, and by their own standards I will judge them. Then they will know that I am the Lord. When any Israelite set up idols in his heart, and puts a wicked stumbling block before his face, and then goes to a prophet, I, the Lord, will answer him myself in keeping with his great idolatry. I will do this to recapture the hearts of the people of Israel, who have all deserted me for their idols. When any Israelites or any alien living in Israel separates himself from me and sets up idols in his heart and puts a wicked stumbling block before his face and then goes to a prophet to inquire of me, I, the Lord, will answer him myself. I will set my face against that man and make him an example and a byword. I will cut him off from my people. Then you will know that I am the Lord, because you did not remember the days of your youth, but enraged me with all these things. I will surely bring down on your head what you have done, declares the Sovereign Lord. Did you not add lewdness to all your other detestable practices? And he said, I will not let you inquire of me. Since you have forgotten me and thrust me behind your back, you must bear the consequences of your lewdness and prostitution. You will suffer the penalty for your lewdness and bear the consequences of your sins of idolatry. Then you will know that I am the Sovereign Lord. I will not hold back, I will not have pity, nor will I relent. You will be judged according to your conduct and your actions, declares the Sovereign Lord. God said to return. God tells God's people to no longer put their minds in vain things or vain places, or return to God by repeatedly proclaiming, you will know that I am the Sovereign Lord, to God's people, and even to foreign nations, Tyre, Sidon, Egypt, Moab, Ammon, Edom, and Gog. And although God punished God's people for their sins, that was not God's want. Even during punishment, God continued to say, repent, turn from your idols, and renounce all your detestable practices. Therefore, O house of Israel, I will judge you, each one according to his ways, declares the Sovereign Lord. Repent, turn away from all your offenses, sin will not be your downfall. Rid yourself of all the offenses you have committed, and get a new heart and a new spirit. Why will you die, O house of Israel? For I take no pleasure in the death of anyone, declares the Sovereign Lord. Repent and live. Then you will remember your evil ways and wicked deeds, and you will loathe yourselves for your sins and detestable practices. I want you to know that I am not doing this for your sake, declares the Sovereign Lord. Be ashamed and disgraced for your conduct, O house of Israel, telling God's people to leave their sins and return to God. Repentance of God's people. There are not many records of God's people's repentance in the book of Ezekiel. However, we have already seen the repentance of God's people in the book of Isaiah and in the book of Jeremiah, prophesied in another place, South Judah. Judgment of the nations. Just as the book of Isaiah and Jeremiah talked about the judgment of the nations, the book of Ezekiel also proclaims judgment on Ammon, Moab, and Seir, Edom, Philistines, Tyre, Sidon, and Egypt. However, even during the judgment of the nations, God repeatedly said, God's people will be restored. God's punishment ends with destruction for other nations, but we must not forget that it is hope through destruction for God's people. Salvation can only be done by God. Now God proclaims his salvation. It will happen in history and in the everlasting new heaven and new earth. God is the sole subject of salvation. God will receive the fundamental penalty for the sin that God's people must bear. First, God said, you are my people, and makes it clear that they will be my people and I will be their God. God will surely make it happen. And he said, I will give them an undivided heart and put a new spirit in them. I will remove from them their heart of stone and give them a heart of flesh. Then they will follow my decrees and be careful to keep my laws. They will be my people and I will be their God. Yet I will remember the covenant I made with you in the days of your youth, and I will establish an everlasting covenant with you. So I will establish my covenant with you, and you will know that I am the Lord. Then, when I make atonement for you, for all you have done, you will remember and be ashamed and never again open your mouth because of your humiliation, declares the Sovereign Lord. When I gather the people of Israel from the nations where they have been scattered, I will show myself holy among them in the sight of the nations. Then they will live in their own land, which I gave to my servant Jacob. They will live there in safety and will build houses and plant vineyards. They will live in safety when I inflict punishment on all their neighbors who maligned them. Then they will know that I am the Lord their God. I myself will tend my sheep and have them lay down, declares the sovereign Lord. I will search for the lost and bring them back the strays. I will bind up the injured and strengthen the weak. But the sick and the strong I will destroy. I will shepherd my flock with justice. I will make a covenant of peace with them and rid the land of wild beasts so that they may live in the desert and sleep in the forest in safety. I will bless them and the places surrounding my hill. I will send down showers in season. There will be showers of blessing. Therefore, you will no longer devour men or make your nation childless, declares the sovereign Lord. I will give you a new heart and put a new spirit in you. I will remove from you your heart of stone and give you a heart of flesh. And I will put my spirit in you and move you to follow my decrees and be careful to keep my laws. Then you, my people, will know that I am the Lord. When I open your graves and bring you up from them, I will put my spirit in you and you will live. And I will settle you in your own land. Then you will know that I, the Lord, have spoken and I have done it, declares the Lord. They will no longer defile themselves with their idols and vile images or with any of their offenses, for I will save them from all their sinful backsliding and I will cleanse them. They will be my people and I will be their God. I will make a covenant of peace with them. It will be an everlasting covenant I will establish with them and increase their numbers, and I will put my sanctuary among them forever. My dwelling place will be with them. I will be their God and they will be my people. All this work for salvation is for God's holy name. Salvation is Jesus Christ, who will come as Messiah. Since the first book of the prophets, Isaiah has already explained the details of Jesus Christ, the Messiah who will come, there is no specific description in Ezekiel as in the book of Jeremiah. However, he said, I will place over them one shepherd, my servant David. He will tend them and be their shepherd. I, the Lord, will be their God, and my servant David will be prince among them. I, the Lord, have spoken, saying that the one who will become the true shepherd will come from the line of David. Prophet's mission. Prophet Ezekiel, who sought for God's mercy, crying, Ah, sovereign Lord, are you going to destroy the entire remnant of Israel in this outpouring of your wrath on Jerusalem? Was called by God and bore the mission as a prophet. God spoke to him, You shall say to them, This is what the sovereign Lord says. Whoever will listen, let him listen. And whoever will refuse, let him refuse. For they are a rebellious house. That's right. Not all will return, but those who remain and the ones chosen by God's grace, mentioned in the book of Isaiah, will return. Restoration of God's people. After the nations see the glory and power of God, God's people will know that God is their God. Many nations also knew that Israel was taken captive because of their sins, and God will bring back God's people and shower them with love, for God's name and with His zeal. God's people will be ashamed and repent their sins after everything is restored. God is the one who captured the Israelites, and God is the one who brought them back to their homeland. And that God will not leave any of His people in a foreign land. God will never again hide His face from His people, but will pour out His Spirit on them. Afterwards, Ezekiel saw the city in his vision. Ezekiel said, In the 25th year of our exile, at the beginning of the year, on the 10th of the month, in the 14th year after the fall of the city, on that very day, the hand of the Lord was upon me, and He took me there. And it has been 25 years since Ezekiel was captured with King Jehoiakim from the second invasion of Babylon. And after another 14 years have passed since the city of Jerusalem was finally destroyed by the third invasion of Babylon. Through this vision, God is showing the glory that will be enjoyed by those who will stand as God's people again through God's grace and sovereign work of salvation. God will come to God's people again, dwell with them by building a new temple. The relationship with God will be restored, new worship will be established, and God's people will go before God. And God will allocate the restored land. I know for God's people, now all these things will be done through the overflowing work of Jesus Christ and the Holy Spirit, who is the true temple. And Ezekiel proclaimed about the water from the temple. The man brought me back to the entrance of the temple, and I saw water coming out from under the threshold of the temple toward the east. The water was coming down from under the south side of the temple, south of the altar. He then brought me out through the north gate and led me around the outside to the outer face facing east. And the water was flowing from the south side. As a man went eastward with a measuring line in his hand, he measured off 1,000 cubits and then led me through water that was ankle deep. He measured of another 1,000 cubits and led me through water that was knee deep. He measured of another 1,000 and led me through water that was up to the waist. He measured another 1,000, but now it was a river that I could not cross, because the water had risen and was deep enough to swim in, a river that no one could cross. When it empties into the sea, the water there becomes fresh. swarms of living creatures will live wherever the river flows. There will be large numbers of fish because this water flows there and makes the salt water fresh. Fruit trees of all kinds will grow on both banks of the river. Their leaves will not wither, nor will their fruit fail. Every month they will bear because the water from the sanctuary flows to them. Their fruit will serve for food and their leaves for healing. The water from the temple will cover everything. Water of the sea will be saved. Meat will increase according to its kind, and there will be plenty of fruit trees to eat along the left and right sides of the river. This is because the water that comes from the sanctuary revives life. This was Ezekiel's vision of the reviving dry bones. And at this time, God said, "Then you, my people, will know that I am the Lord. When I open your graves and bring you up from them, I will put my spirit in you, and you will live. I will settle you in your own land. Then you will know that I, the Lord, have spoken, and I have done it," declares the Lord, saying that the Spirit of God is a spirit of life. That is why Jesus said, "If anyone is thirsty, let him come to me and drink. Whoever believes in me, as the scripture has said, streams of living water will flow from within him." By this, he meant the Spirit whom those who believed in him will later receive. The Bible story, the story of God's zeal, will continue.